from his release Sterling Loves You and Grand River Records. That's Sterling Witt with Built by Design. And Sterling Witt is in the process of on a big tour. Artist and musician Sterling Witt's recent full-length recording, Sterling Loves You. Anthony David, a music critic, wrote in Indie Music Magazine, quote, "Originality is a hard thing to come by these days. It's not a word we use lightly, but it has to be said, Sterling Witt is it. Mastering satirical humor throughout the album is a collection of short, sweet acoustic tunes that are sure to brighten any dull day and leave you with a smile on your face," unquote. Sterling begins his big summer tour this Friday, June 28th, in Indianapolis, the Irving Theater, and he continues with shows in Philadelphia, New York City, Boston, Portland, Montreal, Cleveland, and Detroit. Sterling returns to the area to perform a special birthday show in his hometown of Freeman, Missouri, on July 13th, and also for the Casey Fringe Festival in Kansas City on July 27th. Sterling Witt, thank you so much for being with us on Wednesday Midday Medley.
It's a pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Welcome back to the show. It's been a little bit since we've had you on the show. In the meantime, you've been out traveling all over the world, it seems like.
A little bit, yeah.
Garnering new fans and a lot of critical acclaim for your latest release, Sterling Loves You. Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
Are you excited to get back on the road?
I am. I'm a little restless, so I'm ready to go.
You are going all over, East Coast, West Coast, North, South, all over the place. You're starting off in Indianapolis and then going off to the East, then going up to Canada, to Montreal, and also over to Portland, Maine. So it's mostly in the East,
this
right?
Is mostly Northeast. I just did a West Coast thing not too long ago. At this point, I think after this tour, I'll touched every state in the United States.
On Sterling Loves You, you play with Alan Winkler, who's... Yeah. Did he play on that CD with you?
Yeah, he plays on every song. Yeah, so.
He also is an artist and musician like yourself. Do you think that helps with your meeting of the minds, the two of you working together?
Definitely. I think that's the main reason we get along. We somehow unspokenly understand each other. So it's a relationship that I'm very pleased with.
Alan collaborates with a lot of other musicians also, but I know he's very excited to be working with you. And on the tour, however, you go out by yourself. Is that
this time correct? I'm going by myself, not all the time. This time.
Sometimes he goes with you, depending on the schedule. What do you love most about going out on the road? What's your... it's a challenge.
It's a different town every night, you know? So it's like an explorer, you know? I just pretend like this stuff hasn't been explored yet, and I'm out there for the first time, and I'm meeting all these people, and shaking all these hands, and it's just like a total discovery for me. Every mile is a new part of the world. I enjoy it.
It seems like once you go to a place and you make new fans and you maybe share more of your music with them and do interviews in that area, you have to go back and build on that.
Well, yeah, if they like you. You know, they want you to come back, so hopefully you go back.
You've gotten a lot of great reviews on Sterling Loves You, which is that your fifth full-length release as a musician?
It's hard for me to answer that question because I have all these weird releases that people don't know what to call a release, you know?
And, right.
But I think legally, you're right.
Legal
fifth, yeah. That's my fifth one.
We want to be legal here, that's for sure. So Friday you play in Indianapolis and then take off for Philadelphia. It's really like a different city every day on this tour in a way, isn't it?
It is.
Starting
most
out.
Definitely.
And coming back to perform at your birthday party, you are based in Freeman, Missouri.
Yeah, I'm not really based in
kind
Freeman.
Of in the country, right?
My address is Freeman, and I live in the country. It's a farm with only wild animals on it. It's where I make my art, it's where I do my recording, where I write all my songs, so it's the art farm.
Grand River Records is located there also.
That's its physical location, yeah.
When did you decide to kind of take your destiny into your own hands and create your own record label and really handle all this? Because you do a lot of work in promoting your shows, and there's a lot of art involved in the photographs that you take with each of the shows. Like the appearance on the radio today, that photograph in and of itself is kind of a work of art.
Yeah. Well, I'm an artist, and and I kind of try to make every part of my life reflect the art, so I don't have to go to work, I'm just always in it, I'm always doing it, and so I try to make breakfast as an artist, you know, I try to make my promotional flyers a work of art, and make my conversations with friends, you know, entertaining and interesting, you know, like they should be. And I think that I wanted to be in charge of everything early on when I realized no one else is going to do what I want them to do. I was signed to another label not too long ago. I'm sure many people remember that time. And I just wasn't pleased with the results. And I thought, I can do this, I can do it better, and I'm going to.
I hear you. That's sort of the times that we're living in. I haven't seen this many local releases put out in the last 2 years. In a long time, there's been so many bands are producing their own music now, recording their own music. We're going to play a song from Sterling Loves You. The song is Every Single Second. And while we play that song, you're going to actually make some gifts available to listeners of the show right now. Along with Sterling Loves You, the CD, you have a t-shirt and a special print. Tell us about the package.
Okay, all right. Well, first and foremost, you get my new album, Sterling Loves You. You get a love shirt, which Mark is wearing right now.
Yeah, I'm feeling the love today.
And you get a print of Love Number 11, which is a painting I did. And you get an invitation to my birthday party. You get all that.
So we're going to give away two of these packages, and they'll be held here at the radio station with your name on it that you can come down and pick up. And we're going to make these available to the third and to the fourth caller. I need to let the fourth caller know that we have one line. So if you call, if it's busy, just call back, because the fourth caller will be the person that we answer after we get done with the third caller. Just to let you know that. So the number to call is 816-931-5534. 816-931-5534. Give us a call and we'll give you a couple packages of love from Sterling Witt right here at 90.1 FM. This is Every Single Second from Sterling Loves You. You're the first caller. Peace out.
Every single second, every minute,
every moment, every hour. 90.1 FM, you're the second caller.
Every month, every year.
90.1 FM, you're the third caller. What's your name, please?
I can't love you when you're always out of time machine.
My name is Chrisman.
Define the technological regime. Some believe in heaven.
Okay, Ryan, we're going to have this with your name on it held right here at the radio station at the front desk. You can come in and pick it up. Okay, you'll love it. Thank you, Ryan, I appreciate it. You too, bye-bye. Congratulations, you're the fourth caller. I'm serious. The party is July 13th. There'll be an invitation inside. What's your name? That's right, I thought your name was fitting in here. Oh, great. Well,
Dallin, how do you believe it's perfect?
It is. Well, your name will be on the package that will be held here at the radio station. Thanks, Rita. You too. Bye-bye. Hi, you're the fifth caller. Thanks for calling, and stay tuned. We'll have other things to give away as we get there, I promise. Hi, you're the sixth caller. Thanks for calling. Hi, you're the seventh caller. Thanks for calling. Okay, we'll have this all at once. Do you want these names? Did you want more information than just their names? You probably did, didn't you?
Well, it's okay. At least they got their names.
When they come in to pick them up, you can ask for, like, email and...
That'd be good. If I just had a way to reach them. Just
yeah.
Have my stuff. It'd be nice if I could at least email them or call them.
They both are people that regularly listen, apparently.
I see.
Yeah, we'll figure that out. Thank you. Is there something that we want to talk about that I haven't brought up that you want to make sure we mention?
Not specifically.
New music from Sterling Witt from his release Sterling Loves You on Grand River Records, and we heard the track Every Single Second. And a writer recently wrote that this is one artist that brings to the table effective and slamming songwriting via a highly passionate musical delivery. Drew Blackwell of Vents Magazine. People are taken by your delivery and your style, and you are an original. And one of the ways that you play the guitar is unlike anybody else, right? That's one of your trademarks in a way, isn't it?
I suppose it is. I it was not planned to be that. Certainly it's different.
We want to point out that you play the guitar upside down and backwards.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how you
learned. Big strings on the bottom for those people who are confused, which, or for the guitar players. For people who don't play guitar, I play it upside down. Maybe that just is really confusing to them, I don't know.
But it's not confusing for you, because that's how you learn to play. That's your style.
Yeah, well, I got a right-handed instrument when I was a kid, you know, and I tried to play it the right way, and I could not do it, and I didn't have the correct instrument. Had I had a left-handed guitar, maybe things would be different, but I didn't, and so I just flipped it over, and it came naturally to me.
Well, you're doing a great job. What are you looking forward to most in these upcoming performances that you're doing throughout the rest of June and most of July?
Well, I'm excited to be going into Canada. In Montreal, I've never been there, so I'm kind of anticipating that trip. A lot of these other places I have been to, a couple of them I haven't. So, I don't know, discovering new territories.
Definitely. Montreal is a great music city. There's a lot of amazing things happening up there, a lot of great bands. So that looks like a lot of fun, going up there.
Yeah.
You've really grown as an artist over the last 2 or 3 years. We've had you on the radio show a number of times, and it seems like the amount of people that are aware of your music, that are fans of your music, has just blossomed and grown over the last couple of years. Through your own work, through your own touring, how does that make you feel as an artist to kind of build that audience?
Well, I guess it makes me feel like I'm doing something right, you know? As an artist, I do what I feel like I need to be doing. And I think I'd probably be doing that whether anybody was listening or not. It's nice to know that people are listening.
Definitely. Well, we're going to play one more track from Sterling Loves You. And I want to thank you so much for taking time to be with us on the radio today.
It's always a pleasure, Mark. Thank you.
We'll have you back as soon as you want to come back and join us, and we can make it happen here on the radio show. Sterling Witt has this new album, Sterling Loves You, which is available through iTunes and also through his website. And he begins his big summer tour this Friday in Indianapolis at the Irving Theater, and he continues with shows in Philadelphia, New York City, Boston, Portland, Maine, Montreal, Cleveland, Detroit. Be back for a special birthday show, which we had a couple people call in and win invitations to, and then he'll be playing the Fringe Fest on July 27th. You can get more information at sterlingwitt.com. This is a track that I think you've done live on the show in the past.
That's correct.
It's called Perfect Girl. Sterling Witt, right here at 90.1 FM, KKFI. Thank you, Sterling.
Thanks.
Fireproof, you see, in order to be good enough for me, with eyes that mesmerize, a superhuman in disguise. She's a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's smart, funny, beautiful, intelligent. Everything she ever says is so relevant. She looks so good, she looks so fine. It won't be long before the girl is mine. She's a perfect girl, perfect to me. She's a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's magnificent in every single way, shape, and form. She defied logic the day she was born. She's really old-fashioned, futuristic, thrives on fantasy, and somehow she's still realistic. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. Fireproof, you see, in order to be good enough for me, with eyes that mesmerize, a superhuman in disguise. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. She's a perfect girl, a perfect girl, perfect for me. Thank you.